personal today. Say, my God is for me. And we know that nothing can prevail against us today. Amen. If you're sick in your body, I want you to be healed today. Not because I want it, but because Jesus paid the price for it today. You are healed. You are. It is done. It is finished. If you need relationship restoration, today's the day. Right now, this is the day of salvation. Our God is for us. Nothing can prevail against us. And we're going to declare right now, in the face of insurmountable odds, in the face of any situation, that our God is great and he's worthy. We're going to declare, but God today, to our situation, in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Change.
said, it's better that I go. It's almost hard to understand that sometimes, because you think it'd be so much better to be with him. But he said, it's better that I go, because I've sent you a comforter. I've sent you my substance, the person of who I am in the power of the Holy Spirit. And let me tell you, unlike one Jesus, the Holy Spirit has made his home in all of us. That's why together we are stronger than we are apart. That's why together we are stronger than we are when we're on our own. And today we just loose the strength of God in our hearts and in our lives and into one another. Can you go today and greet somebody around you and loose the strength of God within your brothers and sisters today? Tell them, spring up. Good morning and welcome to Destiny Worship Center. We're so glad that you guys came to worship with us today. Some people were, you know, having Halloween parties last night and stuff, you know, but the real party is always here. So don't ever get it twisted. We're so glad that you guys are here. We're going to take up our tithe and offering right now. I hope you're excited. We're so glad God is doing some really great things here. There's just so much good stuff happening, guys. We're so excited. I just want to encourage you overall just to get involved in everything that we're doing. Stay informed at what's going on, invite a friend, invite your family members. There's a lot of great things that a lot of our staff and ministry are even planning and even going into next year. There's some great things in store. So just stay connected, stay involved, and I promise you, you'll never regret it. So we're going to give today. I want to encourage you also to give today as you have been given to into this place, because there's so many people out there that need what you're receiving here in this place. And so let's give to make that possible, and let's give unto God today, not unto man, not to Destiny Worship Center, not to Pastor Brek or Pastor Trissy, but unto God this morning, because we're giving to him to promote his gospel and his and advance his kingdom. Amen. So we're going to say our confessions here. If you want to give today, you can give by Zelle. Sorry, let me rewind that. You can give by Zelle today, which who doesn't love Zelle and who doesn't have Zelle? It makes it super easy. And then if you haven't downloaded our Church Center app, please download that today. Super simple. It's awesome, you guys. And all of our information is on there, so it's not just for giving. So those are two ways that you can give today. We're going to say our confessions. Don't make me say them louder than you, even though I have a microphone. If you want to give with a cash or check, just raise your hand, and one of our ushers will bring you an envelope. Are you guys ready? So let's speak it. Are you ready? Here we go. As we give today, we are believing the Lord for jobs and better jobs, raises and bonuses, benefits, sales and commissions, favorable settlements, estates and inheritances, interest and income, rebates and returns, checks in the mail, gifts and surprises, finding money, debts paid off and bills paid, scholarships, grants, and tuitions, blessing and increase. We are redefining our legacy, setting new financial standards, thriving as business owners, entrepreneurs, creative artists, and titans of industry. Thank you, Lord, for meeting all of my financial needs, that I abound in all things, that I have more than enough to give into the kingdom of God and promote the gospel of Jesus Christ. Grace happens here. Amen. Those are such powerful words that we speak over ourselves as we give. I just want to encourage you to really mean it when you say it, because what we say has so much power over our lives. Amen. Lord, I just thank you for every giver in this place. Lord, I just thank you for every person represented here, Lord. I thank you, God, that you are so faithful, God, and you are so consistent, God. Lord, when we think about all the ways that you've always made a way, it's endless, God. So, Lord, we come to you this morning with a grateful heart, God, with a thankful heart, Lord, and we just say thank you for meeting all of our needs, God. Thank you, God, just for the simplest things that we do have, God. And Lord, we thank you, God, but you are a God of more than enough. And so, Lord, I thank you that you are pouring out your blessing upon your people, God. Let them have more than enough, Lord. Let them be abundantly blessed as they give today, Lord. And I thank you for those that may not be able to give today, God, that you are supplying and providing above and beyond their wildest dreams. In Jesus' name, we believe today. Amen.
Welcome to Destiny Worship Center. Grace happens here. Grace happens in us and through us. We invite you to join us every Wednesday at 7 p.m. online for our study. The prayer of the righteous avails much. Join us on Tuesdays from 7 to 8 p.m. on the phone prayer line. Catch the vision, now meeting on Thursday nights at 7 p.m. Now DWC in the community. On November 2nd, we're joining the Business Women of God for their Thanksgiving celebration. It's from 11 to 2 p.m. Get ready to join us for an amazing time of worship and giving thanks to God. On December 16th, we're joining Generations Coffee House for their Christmas concert. We love Christmas around here, and we are so thankful to be a part of this amazing event. Scan this QR code to stay in touch with Destiny Worship Center's calendar. We're happy to announce that we are now accepting Zelle.
Going on. Hello, afternoon family. Had a powerful time in the mornings. We've been enjoying. We added, for some of you that don't know, we just added our morning service. Because we started filling up, and it was just time. We were talking about it's time to make room for your family, for your friends, and for this community. And so we're thankful to see you in our second service today, and we just have a lot of good stuff taking place, and I'm excited for this. Thank you, Lord. Let's pray. Holy Spirit, we just thank you. We thank you for your presence that's already here. And Holy Spirit, whatever you want to say, whatever you want to speak, that you would reveal to each and every person here. You care about every individual right where they are. And so, Holy Spirit, I thank you that you speak directly and touch them right where they need it the most, in Jesus' name. Can you say amen? Amen. I just can't help but see and see the emphasis of God, that God is really setting the tone to end strong and go into another new year, confident and seeing the promise of God fulfilled in your life. And so we did a 5-part series not too long back here called Say It, Pray It, Display It. And God was speaking to us and teaching us what it is to not just believe, but to begin to initiate the promises of God in our life. And then a great message from Patrice, a transitional message, that we are overcomers, not victims. I mean, especially when you're in Christ, and even if you are failing, you are failing, you fail forward in Christ. You're never a victim. You're always learning, because through it all, we always come out on top when we know who we are in Him. And then God put this message on my heart. This is a 2-part series, the second part today. We had such a powerful time last week. And it is called It's My Condition. It's My Condition. What's my condition? Blessed is my condition. That blessing is actually a condition. It's our condition in Christ. And so today, I want to prove to you, want to show you, like last week, we proved that blessed is a position, it's a condition that we already have in Christ. It's not something we're trying to earn. See, when we think of the blessing of God, we think, I'm only blessed if I do something to get it. Or I'm only blessed when I have the physical evidence to prove. I mean, look what God has done in my life. But what's really critical, especially as a believer in Christ, is we begin to recognize, when we recognize what God had done in Christ and where the blessing actually resides. That the blessing isn't somewhere out there waiting to get to us. We're going to show you again that the blessing of God blessed us in Christ. And those that accept Christ, that you realize that I'm already blessed. Blessed is my condition. Blessed is who I am. And that confidence, there's a boldness about that. There's a boldness, there's a confidence that you begin to walk in. Because blessed can't hold back. When you know you're blessed and you're blessed because of God, you're not going to just settle for anything. Withdraw because something tells you, circumstances have come and it tries to intimidate you, tries to push you back. Something doesn't happen the way you thought it would at first. But when you know you're blessed, you're not going to let circumstances convince you differently. But instead, you speak, you face your circumstances knowing that you've got to change. Because I know who I am. I know who I serve. I know where God, that God stands with me. And whatever, if that circumstance, if that relationship, if that issue is contrary to God's will in your life, it has to change because you're blessed. Say that with me today. Say, I'm blessed. So many of us have heard the term, I'm blessed to be a blessing. I'm blessed to be a blessing. But as I begin to recognize and see that the blessing resides in me, I started to say that a little bit different because I agree with that. We're going to find out more about that today. But I started to say, I'm blessed, and I'd stop there. Nowadays, I'm blessed when I'm praying. God, I thank you that I'm blessed. Stop right there. And I'm blessed to be a blessing. Why is that important? Because unless you know that you're blessed, you know where the blessing resides, you can't really truly be the blessing God has called you to be to those in your life. The blessing that you are already. And so today we're gonna see this. So let's start. Let's do a little review. Here it is. Before blessed is what I do or the things I have. Blessed is who I am because of Christ. I'm not earning this. I'm not trying to get to a new level so that I'm blessed. I'm already at the right hand of God in Christ. The Bible says that you're at the right hand of God in Christ. Do you realize that you were put there immediately after accepting Christ? That you're already at the highest level with God in Christ. Now, yes, we grow. We have to grow in our understanding. We grow in realizing what that means. We grow in walking with that knowledge. And that's the same thing with this here, that we recognize, look, I'm blessed before I do a thing. I don't need the outward evidence. I am blessed because I'm in Christ. What is that telling me? Blessed is my condition in Christ. What about this? Blessed is my state of being in Christ. So we start to see if blessing is a condition first, it's the condition of in Christ, blessed is my state of being. It's who I am. That changes everything. Because as soon as you get out of bed, before you do any good, you're already blessed. Before you speak a word, you don't have to generate the blessing of God to believe it and to speak it. You're already blessed in Christ. This is critical. So let's prove it again. We're going to go over a few scriptures we went over last week. Ephesians 1:3, here it is. Praise be to God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in the heavenly realms with every spiritual blessing, where and how? In Christ. Notice he says, he has blessed us. It's past tense. He already did it. How? When you accepted him, and the fact that you're in Christ, you're a believer, you're saved, he has already blessed you. Blessing is your condition. Blessing is your state of being right now already. Amen. Come on, y'all. This is good news. 2 Peter 1:2-3, the Apostle Peter, he doesn't use the word blessed, but he begins to describe what we have, and he's basically referring to the blessing of God on our life. Look what he says, verse 2. Grace and peace be multiplied to you in the knowledge of God and of Jesus our Lord, seeing that his divine power has granted to us, that's blessed us, with everything pertaining to life and godliness. He has blessed you. He granted to us these things, right? How does that happen? Through the knowledge of him, Jesus, who called us by his own glory and excellence. Notice that he called you by his own goodness, not yours. He blessed you not by your perfection, but his. He called you through Christ into a place of blessed, into a place of belonging, into a place of love that doesn't change. God loves you no matter what. He's for you. And look what the scripture says. He has given us all things pertaining to, I like this part, life, natural life. This isn't just talking about heaven, y'all. It's talking about natural life. Life, and this is a good thing, godliness. The godliness that you didn't generate, it's his godliness in you. It's his righteousness in you. And that's what puts you in a place of blessing. Oh, this is such great news. So we see here that we are blessed in him. We think and we teach. It's very traditional in the church to teach this, which is not altogether true. We're only blessed if we do something to receive it or have something physical to prove it. That's what we think and that's what we teach. We must understand that blessed is first our condition, our state of being. It's who I am because of Christ. The blessing of God already resides in us and on us because of faith in him. I believe in who I am because of Jesus. I believe that the sacrifice of Jesus, the death, the life, the death, and the resurrection of Jesus included me. That I was there in his sacrifice. My life has been changed forever. I am blessed by God in Christ. I'm blessed by him in Christ. Thank you, Lord. So what we learned that there's a fundamental truth in Scripture, and you'll see it all over Scripture when it comes to blessing. And the fundamental truth is this, is that God's blessing requires righteousness and obedience. Everyone that understands God and godliness will say amen to that. Yeah. So where do we fit in this? What does this mean for us then? Okay? For us, God's blessing is in us because we receive the righteousness of Christ's obedience by faith. Righteousness and obedience is required. And now because of Jesus, we receive the righteousness of his obedience. The word righteousness means right standing. So he's given us right standing with the Father through his obedience. Now, I don't got time. We proved it in Scripture. Go back. That's what DWCLA YouTube's good for. Go back to last week, and we proved in Scripture that we are righteous. We have right standing through the obedience of Jesus, through his obedience, which is incredible. That puts us in a place of blessing. So what is the biblical term? What is the biblical meaning of blessed? Here it is. Blessed means happy, favored, envied, and fortunate. That's you. That's you. One who is given the advantage of relationship with God. You're given the advantage of relationship with God. Blessed has everything to do with relationship. And that's what we have with God through Christ. Christ makes us one with God. Amen. Going on. One, blessed is one who is receiving the provisions and extended benefits of righteousness by God's grace. So we know that the blessing of God fundamentally requires righteousness. Well, we are receiving the blessing, the benefits of Christ's righteousness. That's our right under the new covenant. We are no longer under the old covenant of the law. The law demanded you to do it first to get it. Now, Jesus did it first, so we receive it. Beautiful stuff. So here's what I want you to really capture. We must believe we're already blessed in Christ. That's where it starts. Before it's seen or experienced in the physical, and also in the face of contradictory circumstances. Oh, that's the key right there. See, because if we believe, and this is the problem with believing that blessing has to have an evidence first, or believing that blessed is receiving what we do first. Because when circumstances come and begin to are contradictory to the promises of God, if you don't believe and know that you're blessed, you'll immediately begin to question whether God has blessed you or not. You'll question where you are with God. Is God really with me? But in this, if we can believe, we got to believe it first. We got to believe even before we see it. We have to believe even before there's physical evidence that we are in truth blessed by God in Christ. And especially when circumstances contradict what the Bible just said to us, what we just read. Because if you know and you're convinced and you know that, listen, I'm blessed. I'm blessed because of Christ and what he's done. I'm blessed, period, no matter what. Look it. You are going to be able to sustain and prevail over your circumstances. You will see the blessing of God prevail because you are willing to believe it when you didn't see it. You are willing to believe it, hear me now, and be stubborn in your faith. Even when you didn't see physical proof that you're blessed, you got to believe that. And I know for us, that's something that's been really big for us when we recognize that in our lives is to be able to stand And to stand in the face of not seeing it, but believing and knowing. Look, I'm blessed. So this is going to change. It's going to turn in my favor. I'm going to see health where there's sickness. I'm going to see provision where there's been lack. I'm going to see restoration where there's been division. God is faithful in his word. And he will make a way where it seems to be no way. Because you are blessed. Simply believe it. Somebody one time asked, well, don't you have to do something? And I had to share. I shared with him and to something that I came into the reality of, that sometimes just believing it is the doing. That's the big doing part of it, is being stubborn enough to say, you know what, no, I'm not going to try to do something more to get this to work. I believe your word. I believe what you said, God, and this thing will shift. I'm going to just keep being me, doing what you have me doing, going into places, doing the things that God has called me to do, being obedient to you. I'm just going to keep doing it. I'm not going to do something extra and jump through some religious hoops and to get God's attention. I already have God's attention. I'm already blessed by God. God, I believe that you already love me, that these circumstances, whatever it may be, and we have found that believing, being stubborn about your faith in who you are, really does change things in your life. That believing is doing sometimes. But then as you begin to believe, blessed is able to hear God. If there is a move that needs to be made, blessed knows what it needs to do, what it needs to say, the stand that it needs to take, the path it needs to take. Are you here? Isn't this good news? We must believe we're already blessed in Christ before it's seen, experienced in the physical, and also in the face of contradictory circumstances. So here's the big question. This is my shift today, okay? I'm shifting now into fourth gear. You ready for this? Here's a big question through this all, is how do we manifest God's blessing that resides in us outwardly into the physical? Man, I'm so glad you asked that question. This is a good, good question. This is what happens, is when we realize that we are blessed and the power that actually resides in me because I'm blessed. What we're going to do is we're going to believe it, we're going to do it, we're going to say it, and we're going to give it into manifestation. Someone that has a revelation of being blessed in Christ, they can't help but do what God has called them to do. They can't help but believe and speak with their own mouth to the mountain and tell the mountain, life, this is how it's going to look. This is how it's going to turn out. I'm going to have this career. It's going to turn out this way. It may not happen in my time, but God's time is always perfect. He will make a way. Come on. You start speaking to your challenges with faith. Are you okay? Why does what you say have so much power? Because you're blessed. You're blessed and you know it. You're blessed and you know it. You can rest on that. When we believe it, we do it, we start saying, we start giving because we believe it, and you start to manifest. And this is where it gets good, because see, most people will give in order to be blessed. No, no, no. You start to realize that you are already blessed, so you give. For a lot of people say, well, when I gave, God blessed me in such a big way. No, no, no. What really happened was because you were already blessed, when you responded to God and you gave, the blessing that's already on you manifest. There's an increase that manifests from you giving from the blessing that's already on your life. We're getting somewhere. So here it is. We must understand the purpose of God's blessing in order to see what's in us and on us manifest into the physical. How do we see that? We need to understand the purpose. And here it is. I'm not just blessed exclusively for myself. I'm blessed to be, here's the important part, the blessing. See, when you recognize that God's blessing is on you, you then know that you're the blessing in the world. When you walk in this church, you walk in saying, I'm the blessing. That's going to be the blessing for somebody else. When you go to your work, when you go to your job, you recognize that the blessing is coming to work. The blessing is speaking. The blessing is praying. Whenever you do it, the blessing is doing it. There's so much power in that. So listen, the fruit of true blessing is always generosity. You'll see it, it's the fruit of it. Generosity comes from the root revelation of being blessed. When someone says, I'm blessed, but there's no generosity, I really wonder where they think the blessing came from. Because when you know that it came from God and that you're blessed first because you're in Christ, you recognize that even in all your good and all the good that you get for all your good, still He's the author. He's the finisher. He's the creator. He's the one that gave you grace to do what you do good. Amen. So when you understand that, true blessing can't help but give. That's who you are. Blessed can't just consume. It is compelled to contribute. As we walk in that, I know for us it's the same thing. As we walk in that, you can't help but want to contribute to people's lives. When you understand the capacity that God has placed on you and the grace by which it came, the free blessing of God through Christ, the love that He has shown you when you needed it the most, come on, y'all. When you understand you can't help, you're compelled to give back to those, to give back to somebody else, to help somebody, to be an encouragement, to be better. When you're around people, you want them to be better. And you see your part in God doing that for them as well. That's right. We're so thankful because I know when we started to learn that and just excited when there's a need to be able to meet certain needs. And then it started rubbing off on our son. Now, Philip is just naturally very generous now. He can't stand seeing somebody in need. He wants to help him out. Matter of fact, there's been a few times, he goes out with his friends, and they go out on a Friday night. One time, we'd give him a certain amount of money, and then he went out, had a great time, and then they were going to do some other stuff. So he said, hey, Dad, can I get some more money? I said, well, didn't we give you like $60 last night? What are you doing? And he said, oh, yeah, but I paid for everybody's dinner. I'm like, oh, okay, that's how you roll. All right. I know. We want to go with lunch with you. And that wasn't just a one-time thing. Now we just expect it. Whatever we give him, we don't expect it to stay very long because he's always helping somebody. Wherever they go, he wants to be a blessing to them. But what's interesting, this is the beautiful thing, is every parent wants to know that God is showing himself to their kid. And he has this, he's naturally walking in this blessed spirit, attitude, faith. And money just comes to him now. Like he shows up, and he has a $100 bill. Like, oh, where'd you get that? He goes, oh, so-and-so gave it to me. Like, what? They just kind of just came up and gave it to you. He goes, yeah. Well, what'd you say? What'd you do? They just said they wanted to bless me. And we're like, yep. Yeah. And we tell them, that's the favor of God on you. That's because you're aware. You naturally want to give. And blessed is compelled to be generous in any way possible, from our gifts, our time, words of encouragement, opening doors. Come on, y'all. Blessing flows through all these things that we think are little, that nobody sees. Blessing flows through, but you get ready because it flows back. It multiplies back to those that are generous. Are you here today? Powerful. So last week we were sharing and we saw in Scripture that we were a part of, we are today under the new covenant, that we are a part of the promise of God that God gave Abraham centuries ago. We are a part of the promise of God that he believed and God blessed Abraham. And we found out that we are a part of the lineage of Abraham. And when God made a promise to him, and you're going to see it in a second, that the promise of God to Abraham was that through him, all nations would be blessed. But what he was really referring, what God was saying to him, is Christ is going to come from your lineage. And through your lineage, through your obedience, through you believing me, there will be blessing. How did that blessing come? Through Christ. But it was Abraham believing God before he saw it. So let's read this. Genesis chapter 12. And I want to say this, that if we're going to confess the blessing of Abraham, hear this, then you must accept the calling of Abraham. Let's read it. Genesis chapter 12. He says to Abraham, I will bless you, God says to Abraham, and you will be a blessing. That's where we get that term from. You're blessed to be a blessing, right? And you will be a blessing, and all peoples on earth will be blessed through you. And he was referring to you. He was referring to me. He was referring to us, that Christ would come from his lineage, and all those who believe in Christ, the Bible even says in Galatians, says that those who believe in Christ are Abraham's seed according to the promise. You know what's incredible about that? Is that through Christ, centuries of God's promises belong to you. You. And it's by faith that we believe it, and we then begin to say it, do it, and give it. Oh, such good news. So when we understand this, the calling of Abraham, we are called to be a vessel. We realize that we are called to be a vessel where divine favor flows through. That he's chosen you. Look it. You got to be special to be in the special generation that we're in. I mean, we got to be special, all of us. We are uniquely gifted to be in a generation like this. Because we'd be like, oh, this is a crazy generation. Well, guess what? You in it. You a part of it. You're a part of the party. But understand, you're the blessing in all this stuff. In everything that's going on, you are the blessing. You are the proclamation. Your life proclaims the goodness of a God that loves us, a God that has blessed us. People can look at you and find hope because of the hope that you have found in Christ. Amen. And this is the keys. We understand that we are a part. As being a part of the blessing of Christ, a part of that blessing is preventing the misfortune in the lives of others. That we are blessed to prevent the misfortune. Because remember, the word blessed means what? Fortunate. So now we are the blessed. We are the fortunate. And we have the great privilege of being the blessing in the world that we can prevent the misfortune of other people's lives and step in right at the time of need. Have you had somebody ever step in right at the point of need? We can all say yes. We've all had people that God has used in big ways, even now. And I pray more than ever, and I'm praying more than ever, that we can finally recognize where the blessing resides. Because when you recognize the blessing resides in you, when I recognize it in me, I can't help but understand the power of what I'm carrying. I understand the power of what I have in my life. And if I'm called to this generation, as crazy as it is, that means I have the tools. God has created me with the tools, created you with the tools that it takes. And this is the good part. He blessed those tools. He blessed you to affect the world that we're in right now. This is the power we need. I need you. You need me. We need each other. So look it. If I'm blessed because of Christ, wherever I go, blessing goes. Whatever I do, blessing does. Whoever I partner with, blessing partners with. Whatever I declare, blessing is declaring through me. And whenever I give, get ready, because that blessing on you begins to manifest. You become the manifestation of God Himself. And this is why what you're believing, what you're doing, what you're giving, what you're saying is so significant to your life, to my life, to the world, because what you do, blessing clings to it. We start to realize the blessing of God clings to your doing and clings to your words and clings to your giving. Do you realize it? That you're not generating? It's on what you do. When you know where God's blessing is located, you have to take action. You can't help but begin to take action. So I want to share this with you. This is something to understand. When we begin to see the blessing of God actually manifest physically, when we see that happen physically, it is the kingdom, it is God demonstrating the power of His kingdom, demonstrating publicly His love for you. God is demonstrating His kingdom power, His love publicly for those who believe. And I'm telling you, get ready, because God loves, He loves to proclaim His own. He loves when His children believe in Him and know, even when they don't see it, even when they're not feeling it for the moment, but they continue to praise Him, as even as we were doing today, that we're praising Him, giving Him the glory. We're showing up for church because we're saying, God, You're number one in my life. I want to glorify You. And I'm telling you, get ready for that manifestation, because when you act from that place, you act from a place of power, God is going to publicly, publicly manifest His blessing. It's a public proclamation of His love for you. When you start to see that made manifest. Amen. So we manifest God's blessing through what we believe, do, say, and give. One last scripture. We're going to begin to close. I hope you've been encouraged today already in Jesus' name. 2 Corinthians 9:6-8. Remember this, Paul says. Whoever sows sparingly will also reap sparingly. And whoever sows generously will reap generously. Each of you should give what you have decided in your heart to give, not reluctantly or under compulsion, not forced to. For God loves a cheerful giver. And God is able to bless you abundantly, so that in all things, at all times, having all that you need, you will abound in every good work. Wow. Come on, y'all. That's good news. What is he showing? He's showing the very truth of this. He's showing this, that God's blessing already on you is able to cause your investments to abound in all things at all times. That's the kind of blessing that's on you. He's already granted that to us. And his blessing is able. His blessing on you is able to multiply your investment that way, to honor what you are, who you are. I've heard this said before. Well, it's not about you, it's about others. We make that point. It's not about you, it's about others. Hold up, hold up. And I remember hearing that all my life. And I understand we're trying to make a point. Trying to make the point that, hey, it's not just, is what we really should say about us. But we say, it's not about you. It's about others. And I heard that one time, the Holy Spirit stopped me and said, that's not me. And this is how he gave it to me, especially when we talk about blessing. Look at this. It's never not about you, but it's not just about you. God so desires you to experience his blessing on you. He so desires you to experience his blessing, while simultaneously manifesting his blessing through you to others. The whole sending of Christ was because of you individually. It's always about you. It's always about each one of us. He is very individual in his calling. He's very individual in his love. And yet, he's very corporately in his purpose through us. And what a beautiful privilege to not only be blessed by God in Christ and know that, to have the advantage of God in every circumstance and every situation. You have the advantage. You have the advantage. I hope you feel that way now, that you see it more clearly, that you have the advantage in all circumstances, and you have the authority because of that. And yet he desires you to receive it, so that now we can effectively give also to other people, that we would prevent the misfortune of others. Every day, every time we show up, we are the blessing of God in the world. Amen. Is this not good or what? Come on, y'all. As we start to close, I'm going to give you some takeaways here to this series, the short series, to really live with. This is what we live with right here. But I want to say, when it comes to blessing, obey what God puts in your heart. Hearing God and obey, because the blessing on you, hear me, belongs on a certain path. The blessing on you, many times, is connected with certain people he wants you connected to. The blessing on you is needed through you to specific people. It's needed. It's needed through you to specific people. And so I want to encourage you that that's where we also begin to thrive, when we are cognizant of the voice of the Spirit, and that we don't question it and we just do it. Because God will ask you to do some things. Let's see, what, me? You're talking to the right person? He must have met that guy right there, you know. Believe what he's saying about you. Believe what he told you, and watch, because he always has something behind it, not only for the people that he's going to touch through you, but he has something behind it for you even more so. In Jesus' name, good news. So what's our takeaway today? Number one, before blessed is what I do or the things I have, blessed is who I am because of Christ. Believe that. Number two, I'm not just blessed exclusively for myself. I'm blessed to be a, or what about the, blessing. And thirdly, we manifest that blessing through what we believe, do, say, and give. It comes from the inside and on us into the physical as we live it. Praise the Lord. Let's give God a praise right now for his blessing. Thank you, Father. Thank you for your blessing. Thank you for the blessing that you've given us by grace in Christ today, that we can be confident in that this morning. And I pray for each and everyone here. God, I pray for the revelation, that light bulb to turn on inside our hearts, that we would begin to see it and believe it and stand in that. I pray confidence. I pray boldness. Amen. Yes, God, help us to begin to live what we believe. Live from the blessing. Do it, say it, give it, pass it on. Holy Spirit, I thank you for your blessing that begin to manifest into the physical like never before. That you proclaim your love in a very powerful way in the places that we need it the most. And God, in doing that, you're going to show people, you're going to show how real you are through us. And we receive that. We receive that calling. We receive the calling of being the blessing in our generation. In Jesus' name. If you believe that, say amen. Amen. Let's thank him. And every day, wake up thanking him, praising him, knowing who you are. I'm going to pray one more prayer. And even those online, it's so good to have you on DWCLA. We're glad that you're all tuned in from your houses, from your homes, wherever you're tuned in from. We love you guys. So thankful that you're here with us. Let's pray this prayer. If you've never received Jesus as your personal Lord, you've never accepted him as your Savior, because that's where the blessing starts. That's where we become who we are. Let's all say this prayer. What we're going to do is we're going to pray. We're going to ask Christ. We're going to ask. We're going to receive him as Savior and Lord of our lives. So if we could all say this out loud, and that way, for those that are saying it, you're saying it for the first time. Don't say it for me, anyone else around you. Say it to God as you pray this prayer. Are you ready? Even those online, let's do this. You're going to accept Christ, and you're going to accept this blessing today. Let's say, Father God, I believe that Jesus Christ, he lived, he died, and he resurrected for me. I believe that through Jesus, all my sins are forgiven. Past, present, even future. Say, I receive Jesus as my Lord, my Savior. So today, I also accept that I am blessed. I believe it, and I ask that you lead me in that blessed life. In Jesus' name, amen. Praise the Lord. We're so glad, so glad. If it's your first time, we will have our prayer partners up here to pray with you. If it's your first time and you've received Christ, come on up here. If you're asking what next, we'd like to help you out. If it was your first time at Destiny Worship Center, we just pray that you had a great time. And come back. Invite your friends, your family. We have a barbecue, y'all. Food out there. I hope some of it's left. I know all the first service brunch people, they were brunching. Believe me, they were brunching out there. No, we have some food left. And just go out there, grab something, stay around. God bless you. Let's say our motto today. Let's say it. This is what we say here at Destiny Worship Center. Grace happens here. Grace happens in us and through us. All right, y'all. Bless you. We love you. God bless you. And Friday, ladies, we have our designer ladies here at 7 o'clock. Don't forget, be here. God has been doing some phenomenal things there, so be a part of that. All right. Have a great week.